Colt to possess a weapon. This is a very difficult time, as we know, for students and parents, and so many I know of students and parents here in this county and around this state are afraid. You all have likely seen reports of incidents of other students making threats today at various schools around our state. In each of these incidents, police, law enforcement took charges, they made arrests, acted very swiftly, as we take incidents like this very seriously across this state. This is a time for all of us as a community and a state to come together and remain vigilant. Students must be supported and encouraged here in this community and across this state to contact a member of their school faculty with any and all concerns of suspicious activity that they may see. Local, state, and federal law enforcement will continue to work together around the clock in relation to this incident here and any other incidents that come up around this state that raise concern to the safety of our students, faculty, and citizens here in the state of Georgia. Additionally, Colt Gray, that was arrested yesterday for this incident, has now been charged with 4 counts of felony murder. And again, we will continue to work tirelessly to complete this investigation as we move forward. I will go ahead and mention to you, and as I say sometimes, I'm going to go ahead and apologize to you. As y'all all know, that this is a murder investigation. It is a very serious investigation, one that we take serious, one that we will continue to diligently work on and be very thorough with it, with the GBI and our local partners here. So you'll have to forgive us if we don't answer a lot of the questions that you ask. I know you have many, and we wish we could answer many of them for you, but we still obviously want to maintain the integrity of this investigation because it has a long way to go for it to be finished. Again, I also want to remind everyone that we need to continue to pray and support the victims that were involved here, the school teachers, the faculty, the students, obviously those that lost their lives, their families, and those that were injured. So I'd like to call on the sheriff to come and give you a brief update on the status of those that were injured from yesterday's event. Thank you.
Thank you, Director Hosey. As Director Hosey said, I'd like to say that obviously we're lifting up those families. Our hearts are hurting for them, our kids, our students, our teachers. But the 9 injured, I am very happy to say, will make a full recovery. And that's a testament to the response that we had. In my opinion, the response that medical staff responded with, in my opinion, and we're very happy to say that they will make a full recovery after that response. Again, please lift up our community. Please keep these children, these teachers. We call them teachers, but I call them heroes. We met with them today. Emotions are very high, obviously. But we told them that we love them, we love our teachers and what they do, and we're very happy at the fact that they stood in the gap between evil to protect their children, and we want to include them in the lives that were saved as well yesterday. But I wanted to report to you that all 9 people that are injured will expect to make a full recovery. Thank you.
Are they still in the hospital?
Several of them are still in the hospital. Some have been released.
Well, I'm gonna leave it as how I mentioned it in the release, that he knowingly allowed him to possess the weapon.
Director, can you tell us about how the arrest happened today? Did he turn himself in? Did you guys make contact with them? How did that go with investigators this afternoon with that arrest?
I'm honestly not familiar with the details. Okay. All I can tell you is that he is in custody at this time.
And is it likely anyone else will be arrested in this case?
It's difficult to say at this point in time. We're obviously still investigating this, following all leads, all evidence, and we'll set to see where it takes us as we progress forward. The arrest was made when we had the probable cause to make the arrest.
Do we know when his first court appearance will be?
I'm not sure. No,
ma'am. Did the dad bring him to school?
I'm not sure about that either. I'm sorry.
Are you able to explain the charges and how he has more charges than
the suspected? Not in great detail. The biggest thing, as I mentioned earlier, is that he is in custody at this point in time. His charges are directly connected with the actions of his son and allowing him to possess a weapon.
Sheriff, will he be housed in your facility? Is that where he'll be held? How does that move forward?
He'll be held in the Barrett County Detention Center.
Will his mugshot be available tonight, or will it take some time until tomorrow to get a mugshot?
It depends on how long it takes us to book him, but if it's available, we can get that to y'all tonight.
Sheriff,
if not tomorrow.
You said some good news and some have been released. Do you know the numbers of patients that have been released, victims?
I don't want to speak to that because I don't know the exact number, but I know that I want to just report that all nine would make a full recovery and be able to leave the hospital.
Sheriff, there were nine people that were injured. Do we know if they are a mix of students and teachers or staff, or are they just students?
I believe two were adult teachers, and the rest, which would be seven, would be students.
Director, can you explain whether there's precedent for charges like this?
I'm sorry?
Can you explain whether there's precedent in the state of Georgia as far as the GBI is concerned for the father or parent to be charged with a crime?
I don't have any details on any history of it, but I would venture to say it's not something new.
Can you tell us about the evidence that led to these charges?
No, ma'am. That's part of the ongoing investigation. I apologize.
Sheriff, after all this time with him being able to talk with investigators, you were pretty strong yesterday. We're saying this was an evil act. It's very sad, obviously. But looking back at what the 14-year-old has been able to say to investigators over the last 24 hours, can you reflect on just what this community is facing after what he allegedly did at this school?
What we're facing? Heartbreak. We're heartbroken. A young person brought a gun into a school, committed an evil act, and he took lives, and he injured many other people, not only physically but mentally. But I'm proud of Barrett County. I'm proud of our superintendent. I'm proud of these teachers. I'm proud of these schools, and I'm proud of where I live. And we'll get past this. If you see behind me up here on the hill, we got a vigil going on at our flagpole. I welcome you to go see those kids and those young people that are hurting.
Director, can you please explain whether you're still expecting more charges?
I think I answered that earlier. Our investigation is still ongoing, so we'll see where things go with our investigation, and I'll leave it at that.
Thank you so much. That's all we have for tonight. Continue to follow the GBI on X. Please monitor our website. We did not anticipate another update, but as you can see, it's fluid. Things are developing. Again, we appreciate your patience and your support and your continued prayers for the victims. Thank you.